So I went to Bletchley Park a little while ago, and the main thing that stuck with me was how doable everything seemed. Everything's physical and electromechanical, it's all wires. There's very little going on in sort of integrated chips or anything hidden away. So it looked complicated, but like something we could do.
Yeah, so Bletchley Park was the covert code-breaking section of the British military during the war. Enigma was one of the main problems they were trying to solve. Alan Turing was one of the main scientists, computer scientists, working on the problem. Turing developed the famous bomb machine, which was what ended up cracking Enigma, and is considered one of the first computers.
Tom is brilliant, because I just sort of said, would you like to build an Enigma machine? And he said, here are my plans.
Despite being like relatively simple by today's standards, the kind of number theory and complexity that five rotors can give is quite, you know, astounding. So it's an interesting study for kind of cryptanalysts and people interested in number theory.
Because Tom's done such a brilliant job of keeping it true to the original, is actually complete enough that if you were to write a message on one of the real Enigma machines at Bletchley Park, we would be able to use our Enigma machine to decrypt that message and actually read it back and send our own. So we'd love to be able to bring it out and let students actually have a go and create their own encrypted messages using a piece of kit that was used in World War II. And sometimes for outreach as well, hopefully we'll actually be able to take it around and get some school kids going and inspire them.